My name is Mel Bernstein, and they call me the most armed man in America. I have over 4,000 weapons in my name, over 200 machine guns. I have mortars, bazookas, tanks, half-tracks, attack jeeps, flamethrower, and everything I have is legal in the state of Colorado. This is the front door at Dragoman's, my gun store. Right now, you're not a trespasser, you're a target.
3% of Americans own, yeah, according to a recent study, over 50% of guns. You probably fall into that group.
Yeah.
Why do you think so few people have such a large concentration of weapons?
You get addicted to them, you know, it gets in your blood. We're driving up my property now, and there's all kinds of warning signs, as you can see. If anybody comes on your property and threatens you with bodily harm, it's legal to shoot them. Colorado law. They should have that nationwide. This is one of the first signs they see when they drive up Dragoman Drive. I actually have 6 shooting ranges.
Whatever the killer used, that's what they want.
They want to feel the firepower. They want to have the gun just like that to show people.
So they're inspired in a way.
Oh, yeah. The business, it goes up. We've been selling more guns in the last 3 weeks than we did in the last 8 months. This is just like the AR-15 that the shooter used in Sutherland, Texas, in the church. They all adapt to a 30-round magazine, a 40-round magazine, even a 100-round magazine. And all they do is snap right in. And you're ready to go. This is the same type of gun that was used in Vegas. With the bump stock, this will actually shoot and fire over 500 bullets per minute. This is a 12-gauge pistol grip shotgun, just like the kids used in the Columbine massacre over there. And they used one similar to this one, too. We sell real man's guns. It's very, very easy to buy a gun in the state of Colorado. And within less than 15 minutes, you can walk out the front door here with a rifle or a shotgun. The whole Midwest is almost like Colorado, the same laws.
What do you think then when you saw Vegas, when you saw that on the news?
Well, the guy looked 100% normal. Nobody could ever know that somebody like that is going to do something like that. For him to shoot that many people really probably pissed him off. He just hated people all of a sudden. You know, that happens.
And then there's a lot of concern about mental health and guns. What kind of background checks, mental health checks, do you have?
Well, there's no real, you know, you could be good, 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 and then all of a sudden you get a brain tumor. They're not going to find that out right away.
How much does your weapons collection cost?
Well, just the machine guns are almost $2 million. And then the regular guns here, the inventory, is probably another $1.5 million. Military vehicles, maybe $3 million.
Your wife died in an explosion on this property some years ago.
The Discovery Channel, you know, we were doing a film for my own show. We were filming for months and months, and just the last 30 seconds, all we had to do is walk through a whole barrage of smoke, and one of the smoke containers turned into a rocket and went right past me and right through her and killed her. So they canceled and threw away the whole show. Here's my house over here. We're pulling up to it. I live by myself, and this is all I really need. Here, come on in. Yeah, I got it all fixed up like oldies. Brings back a lot of memories to me when I grew up in New York.
What was it like growing up there in Brooklyn?
Tough neighborhood back then. I used to get beat up all the time. I had to pay 25 cents to the bullies for protection, you know, every week.
So you were bullied when you were young?
The bullies, yeah. They bullied me. And then when I got older, I bullied the other kids. You know, it's a whole cycle. Let me show you my bedroom here. We got like about 8 machine guns in here. We got sawed-off shotguns. We got M16s. We got handguns all around the whole area. You know, I have 4 girls that live with me. This is Betty. We got Betty here. We got Jill. We got Jennifer. I need somebody to talk to, you know, tell my problems. They never really ask to go shopping or out to eat. They're very polite. They like that. And, you know, we talk about machine guns and hot rods and, you know, stuff I like. I don't really care what she likes because she never says nothing anyway. I'm real nice to him. When it gets cold, you know, in the winter, I even put underwear on. You know, I'm a good boyfriend. Come home after work, I put the jukebox on. I talk to the girls. We have a cup of coffee. I start the fire, you know, if it gets cold. I play with my guns. I watch TV, and I go to bed. This whole house fixed up like this puts me back in my era, back in the 60s, where I belong.